Health technology assessment is really a broad multidisciplinary approach to the systematic evaluation of technologies, and it has gained a lot of importance over the last 20 years. The objective is really to summarize systematically evidence about existing clinical effectiveness, cost effectiveness, and to then provide a bridge, if you will, between the evidence and policy making. And HTA as a discipline is really, or the name HTA is really used for HTA reports, like the very formal HTA reports by NICE in the UK, but also to efforts like CMS effort in coverage reviews, for example, that's also considered health technology assessment more broadly. One of the ultimate driver of HTA and the increasing importance of HTA is the limited resources in healthcare around the world. So decision makers need to have solid evidence when they make decisions about whether or not to adopt a technology, whether to cover it, and if so, how much they pay for it. In addition to this primary objective, there's really a lot of overlap also with evidence-based medicine and comparative effectiveness research. So understanding the real clinical effectiveness in various subgroups of populations, comparing one approach to another. When you think of prostate cancer, for example, there are four or five different competing approaches, and so health technology assessment, or in this case, comparative effectiveness research, really tries to delineate the evidence to help decision makers factor which is the best and most efficacious treatment for patients that should be adopted. Health technology assessments really have a number of audiences. Payers, definitely in many countries or cases, payers are national healthcare systems. When you think of the US, you have Medicare as the government payer, and you have private payers, so they are clear audiences of health technology assessment reports and findings. The other entities are clinical societies, providers in general, but also patients and beyond that, patient groups. With respect to early medtech innovation, certainly there's a high likelihood that the technology will be evaluated fairly soon after it got regulatory approval in cases where it's a deep pocket investment for the healthcare system. And in cases where it's a commodity type product with established evidence, maybe from other technologies, it's not as likely that an HTA will be performed in the early years of adoption.